Good evening, everyone. I hereby call to order this special meeting of the Council of the City of Lancaster for inaugural ceremonies and for our organizational meeting of the term. First and foremost, I want to thank you all for being here, for the role each and every one of you have played in coming to this date, and for your unending service to the City of Lancaster. Indeed, that is why we are all here. Just a couple items of business. Of course, this meeting is being live streamed, so you are being recorded. Please take a moment to silence your cell phones. And then I just want to give some special recognition, first and foremost, to the members of the Syrian community here in Lancaster who have come to be with us this evening. What makes Lancaster a really incredible place is that we are able to bring people from all nationalities, all walks of life, economic, social, racial, and religious together to kick us off into what hopefully is an even more fruitful 4 years than the past four. If you have other translation needs, our language access coordinator, oh, and the doors are shutting, will be just outside the double doors there, and so you can free to go there if you have other needs. We are requiring, as you, oh, there she is. We are asking, as you have all already obliged, that we keep our COVID sense about us and that we all wear masks during the ceremony. And if we can be conscious of social distancing, please sit as you are comfortable. If you need to take a couple of seats, please feel free. You know, we take this very seriously and we value your health. We're grateful that you're here and we hope that you'll be here for the next one. So with all of that, thank you again so much. Thank you to my council colleagues, mayor, and to the members of the staff of Lancaster City who are here this evening. In fact, before we go any further, can we have a round of applause for the persons employed by the City of Lancaster this evening? Thank you. We now go to our invocation. Moving along with the program, I would like to invite Mr. Mukarram Sayed from the Islamic Community Center of Lancaster to call us together this evening.
Thank you. Auzubillahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim wal asr. إن الإنسان لفي خسر إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. In the name of God, the most beneficial, the most merciful, by time. Indeed, mankind is in loss, except for those who have believed and done righteous deeds and advised each other to truth and advised each other to patience. I begin with the greeting of Abrahamic faith, Assalamu Alaikum, meaning may peace and blessings be upon all of you. I am Mukarram Sayed, a member of the Board of Trustees of the Islamic Community Center of Lancaster. Thank you for having me here today. I shall now proceed with a short Islamic prayer. O Lord, we stand before you asking to shower the city of Lancaster with your blessings. As children of your creation, we seek your wisdom and courage as we continue striving to build this city where everyone can live in peace, harmony, and to our full potential, and where no one is forgotten. A city which is inviting to all of your creations, not just accepting of, but cherishing all our diversity and the strengths it brings. O Lord, with all that is happening in the world today, we ask that you remind our leaders and all of us the responsibility to serve the common good of all. Grant them and us the understanding to do what is right and good. Listen patiently and receptively when it is time to listen and speak out when it is time to speak out. Let their or our words and actions then bring peace, harmony, and success to this city we call home. So be it. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Now, as you are willing and able, I invite you to join me in rising for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Mr. Harris, if you would please call the roll of members.
Yes, Mr. President. Mr. Arroyo.
Here.
Ms. Baker.
Here.
Ms. Craig.
Here.
Ms. Diaz.
Here.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Here.
Mr. Soto.
Here.
And President Smith-Waddell.
Here. Thank you, Mr. Harris. We turn then to the approval of the council minutes for December 21st, 2021. I'll hear a motion.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Council comments on the minutes. Hearing none, Mr. Harris.
Mr. Arroyo.
Aye.
Ms. Baker.
Aye.
Ms. Gregg.
Aye.
Ms. Diaz.
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Aye.
Mr. Soto.
Aye.
And President Smith-Waddell.
Aye. Now we get to the good stuff. Mr. Harris, have you received the appropriate certificates of election for the newly elected city officials?
Yes, Mr. President. I've received the certificates and they are filed in the city clerk's office.
Excellent. I would now invite Magisterial District Judge, the Honorable Jody Richardson, to administer the oath of office to Mayor Sorace.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Mayor-elect Danene Sorace.
I, Mayor-elect Danene Sorace.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
Obey and defend.
Obey and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge.
And that I will discharge
the duties of my office.
The duties of my office.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
Congratulations, Mayor.
Thank you so much. So having just taken a COVID test and am negative, I'm going to remove this for the portion of my remarks this evening. I am so honored and delighted that all of you could be here tonight. Here we are, 3 days into 2020, and our experiences as a community have continued to grow and shift over the past year to inform our priorities for the coming year. Tonight, in my fourth State of the City address, and the first, in my second term as mayor, I want to do two things. Reflect on our accomplishments from the last year and highlight the priorities you've helped us elevate for the next 4 years in our work to build a stronger and more equitable Lancaster block by block. First and foremost, I'm proud of the way your public servants have showed up in 2021. Our core values of quality, teamwork, integrity, and respect guide our work as we deliver essential services. Your city team continues to respond to calls for fire and police assistance with speed and effectiveness, provide clean water every time you turn on the tap, improve our stormwater and wastewater efforts every single year, ensure our public parks and streets are safe and accessible, and support economic development in ways that make our city the most vibrant in central Pennsylvania. And we continue to do all of this under the cloud of a pandemic. We've continued to navigate the challenges of COVID without the support of a county health department to provide the data and guidance of a coordinated community response. We doubled down to ensure our residents were aware of risks and resources and maintained essential services without interruption for the past 21 plus months. But we are clearly not out of the woods yet. We're starting off 2022 by hosting vaccination and booster clinics in partnership with Union Community Care. We're committed to doing our part to get through this and move into long-term recovery. I want to thank all of the first responders and healthcare professionals for your tireless efforts to protect our community and to care for us when we fall ill. But more than anything, I'm most proud that we have done more to advance people-centered governance than any city administration before us. We prioritized engaging our residents in meaningful ways at every turn, in every single department. I'm excited to share with you tonight how this is going and what we are doing in the context of our strategic plan. So our strategic plan for the next 4 years echoes those same priorities from my first term. The four pillars are strong neighborhoods, safe places, sustainable economy, and sound government. And I'm briefly going to touch on each of these tonight. So strong neighborhoods. Our neighborhoods are about our people. I'd like to paint a picture for you of what people-centered public investments look like by telling you a little bit about Milburn Park, which was recently redone. This project was elevated several years ago by neighbors in the blocks around Milburn Park, a park at the center of a block between Rockland, Juniata, Lime, and Dauphin Streets. An opportunity arose in 2021 to partner with Kaboom and the Pennsylvania Municipal League, where I am president, to rebuild Milburn Park during the PML annual conference. This group of elected officials and municipal staff from all over Pennsylvania, plus neighbors, friends, and sponsors, as well as other volunteers, worked together on this really awesome project. The very, very best part was having a group of children from the neighborhood literally help design the park and select the playground equipment that best fit their vision. Over a period of just 5 days, volunteers from inside and outside the neighborhood joined together to rebuild this park and honor the legacy of Violet Milburn, the park's namesake, who for years served as grandma to many children who grew up in this neighborhood, including one of my colleagues at the City of Lancaster. A highlight, to be sure, was gathering in front of the new playground with some of the children who helped plan the park, Mrs. Milburn's family and neighbors, to cut the ribbon on this restored neighborhood asset. We still have some work to do in the spring with final landscaping, plantings, and paving, and this gem will long serve our residents in the southeast. We've also expanded our online tools to include Engage Lancaster, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, please go online and check it out, where public projects are posted for input and feedback. And for neighbors who want to go deeper, our Neighborhood Leadership Academy is for you. To date, 61 neighbors have graduated from this academy, and many of them have brought new ideas to fruition in their neighborhoods. Our engagement efforts will go on steroids in 2022 with the addition of 11 AmeriCorps Vista volunteers who will be serving in engagement capacities across all of our departments. These positions are grant-funded by the Corporation for National and Community Service, a federal program, and we are delighted to be able to be hosting 11 Vistas. The other big explicit goal with strong neighborhoods is housing. You've heard a lot about this. And we've just made the biggest commitment to affordable housing in city history with the allocation of $5 million in American Rescue Plan Act funding. This funding will help facilitate the creation and preservation of hundreds of affordable units across the city, and it can't happen soon enough. Lastly, in 2022, we will finish the first comprehensive plan the city has completed in nearly 30 years. This process has required incredible time and investment by our staff, dedicated funding, including many grants, and the most sustained and far-reaching engagement effort we have done to get deep and wide participation in a plan that will guide the city for the next 20 years. Those policy priorities and land development and more. Safe places. So when discussing public safety, we often think about the obvious, traffic safety, fire, police, and we've accomplished so much in these areas, from our plan to eliminate pedestrian injuries and fatalities through our Vision Zero plan, to ensuring we have the necessary infrastructure for timely fire response. We see this bright new fire station here on the screen, to advancing 21st century policing. And yet, safety is so much more than that. We have the Bureau of Police to thank for kicking off the city's hiring of social workers. And here I want you to meet Grace Menser, Sonia LeBron, and Leilani Tran. Grace and Leilani work within the Police Bureau, and Sonia is our new housing caseworker. Additionally, we've also partnered with the Lancaster City Alliance to fund and hire a downtown outreach specialist to make sure that those who are on the streets are connected to resources that they need in partnership with the Homeless Coalition. This people-centered approach is about taking a holistic look at safety and working to support our neighbors to prevent emergencies and provide support that our first responders aren't equipped to do. Moving on, third priority, sustainable economy. So we know that the foundation of a strong community is a sustainable and equitable economy that works for all of our residents. You may not have associated our LEAD program with local economy, but the work of the city's LEAD program demonstrates the ripple impact that one good job and intentional public investments can make. We talked a lot about the city's grant-funded LEAD remediation program and the impact that that has on our children. Of course, we want to make sure our children are safe from LEAD poisoning. What we haven't talked much about yet are those who do the remediation, local contractors and workers who are trained to do this work safely, and who now have a pipeline of literally hundreds of houses that the city is supporting to improve. John Wright, pictured here, is one of those contractors who knows that a good job becomes a great job when it can have a positive impact in the community. All of this work improves our local economy and will put more than $10 million into our neighborhood, into our communities. And some of those dollars are going to go directly to contractors like John's J.F. Wright Enterprise, LLC, to grow their businesses right here in Lancaster. And just to say that this picture of John was taken on Atlantic Avenue, and you really got to know the city to know Atlantic Avenue. But Atlantic Avenue was part of John's paper route when he was a boy. And so helping this neighborhood in particular is very special to him. In 2021, the Lancaster Office of Promotion has moved under the Department of Neighborhood Engagement, and we will be relaunching in 2022 with an expanded vision, more programming, and a new name that reflects the breadth and tools the office offers our community. But one thing that hasn't changed is its commitment to promoting our small businesses. Though it's currently closed due to a recent fire, but sort of closed because we have opened up at Central Market 3 days a week, the Welcome Center will fully reopen in 22 and continue to work to ensure the vibrancy of our downtown and our neighborhoods for residents and visitors alike, making an equitable economic recovery from COVID a really huge priority. And lastly, sound government. Sound government is about ensuring those services are provided and making government as effective as it can be as an entity that is owned by and accountable to its residents and stakeholders. One new thing we're excited to roll out today, along with the online version of our strategic plan, is the first draft of our data dashboard on LancasterBlockByBlock.com. So here you can see some initial data points and data visualizations, including new maps showing where public investments are made throughout the city. The housing investment map, for example, shows actual locations where this administration has invested in LEAD, critical repair, housing rehab, and new housing towards our goal of building a stronger and more equitable Lancaster block by block. In a city where 35% of our residents speak a language other than English, and we are experiencing translation right now in the moment, providing access to services in languages that work for them is essential. And as Council President pointed out, we have our own Zaira Falou, who has led this work for the city, and Amr El Fayad is one of our key partners to help, who helps us with the translation, our translation efforts. Amr, who's wants to raise his hand in the back, came to the U.S. more than 10 years ago and believes that fostering a culture of welcome allows people with different perspectives and experiences to work together on common concerns. We believe this too, which is why we're building a culture of service and inclusion among those who work for the city, where the city workforce reflects the residents of the city and where city employees serve the government, serve the community, and not the system of government. In 2021, we hired the city's first chief data and technology officer, who is leading a significant investment into modernizing our technology by bringing our resident communications, permitting, code enforcement, and work order management into the 21st century. So, y'all, this is like the weeds of city government, and it is so important that we do this well. This work has started with the launch of Rosie, a chatbot built with artificial intelligence a few weeks ago. So if you've been on our website, you've met Rosie. She is embedded right there when you visit LancasterCityPA.com, and she not only answers your questions about city services, but is also continuously learning to give you better results in the future. In the next few months, we'll launch Fix-It Lancaster, a system that simplifies requests for assistance and information and provides incredible data for our team about how we can improve customer service and deliver our services more efficiently. We'll be launching new permitting systems that will simplify and streamline applications and allow contractors and property owners to file building permits online and track progress online. Again, these seem like really in the weeds, but this is the nuts and bolts of what your city does day in and day out. We'll also move to mobile code enforcement that will allow our housing inspectors and public works employees to cover much more ground in the same amount of time and ultimately improve the quality of life in our neighborhoods. These technology upgrades are about improving the experience the customer has with the city and improving the bottom line, which, as you know, I keep talking about. Year after year, you've heard me ring the bell about the city's structural deficit created by state law. This inequitable and unfair refusal by our elected representatives in Harrisburg to improve common sense solutions must be addressed by the next legislature and governor. Cities across the Commonwealth are in the same boat as Lancaster, and Harrisburg, we need you to act so we can continue to provide these essential services and reduce the property tax burden on those with the least capacity to pay right here in Lancaster County. Okay, so what I've talked about is just a taste of what we are up to. There is so much more work that your public servants are leading. And building a stronger, more equitable Lancaster takes each of us. So we're also asking you to do your part as neighbors and residents. There are so many ways that you can do that, but one of the most impactful ways is that you can vote. It seems so simple. At the end of the day, government only works for us when we are part of it. Having a responsive, representative, engaged, committed government is possible at every level if we demand it. The massive investments we have seen in 2021 in things like infrastructure, the expanded child tax credit, and the American Rescue Plan were made possible by representatives who responded to the needs of communities like Lancaster across this country. There are critical elections that are coming up in 2022, State House, Governor, U.S. Senate, and Congress. If you're here tonight, you're likely already planning to vote in 22. But we need to make sure that others do too. So Lancaster City continues to fall behind the county, the state, and the country in voter participation. And that has to change for Lancaster to truly reach our potential. So I encourage all of you to help lean in and help us register more voters here in the city of Lancaster in 2022. Lastly, I just want to end with a thank you. It has been an honor. been an honor to serve as your officers of treasurer and controller who helps to support and keep your government running. And so I want to thank you very much for your partnership and for the productive working relationship that we have that puts our residents and their well-being first. There are shared set of values that we have together that make this work possible. And for that, I am truly grateful to each and every one of you. Thank you. All right, let's get going by finishing this inauguration and getting back to work as your public servants. And so it is my honor to administer the oath of office to council members elect and fiscal officers elect. And I am going to begin, I will call each person to the podium here. I will ask you, just like I did, to raise your right hand for the expression of the loyalty oath. And then you, individually at the conclusion of everybody's opportunity to, that after everyone is sworn in, have an opportunity to say a few marks if you would like. So first, I would like to call Councillor Craig. Councillor Craig, would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me? I, Faith Craig.
I, Faith Craig.
Being duly elected as a member.
Being duly elected as a member.
Of the City Council.
Of the City Council.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
Obey and defend.
Obey and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth.
Of Pennsylvania.
Of Pennsylvania.
And that I will discharge the duties.
And I will discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
Congratulations, Councillor Craig. Thank you for your service. I would like to next call up Councillor Smith-Waddell. Would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me? I, Ismael Smith-Waddell.
I, Ismael Smith-Waddell.
Being duly elected.
Being duly elected.
As a member of the council.
As a member of the council.
Of the City of Lancaster.
Of the City of Lancaster.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
Obey.
Obey.
And defend.
And defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And that I will discharge the duties.
And that I will discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
Congratulations, Councillor.
Thank you, Mayor.
Next, Councillor Diaz. Would you please raise your right hand? I, Janet Diaz.
I, Janet Diaz.
Being duly elected.
Being duly elected.
Mr. Smith, would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me? I, Vincent Derek Smith.
I, Vincent Derek Smith.
Being duly elected as treasurer.
Being duly elected as treasurer.
Of the City of Lancaster.
Of the City of Lancaster.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And that I will discharge the duties.
And I will discharge the duties.
Of my office with fidelity.
Of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations, Mr. Smith. Thank you. Let's give them a big, big round of applause. And now I invite any remarks from new council members, fiscal officers. The podium is yours.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, everyone, for being here. The City of Lancaster is focused on our priorities, strong neighborhoods, safe places, sustainable economy, and sound government, as the mayor said a little while ago. Our city is working on historic investments in affordable housing, making government more accessible, making great strides in the 21st century policing. As I continue to be a part of this body, I will do the job that you elected me to do. Thank you.
Happy New Year, everyone. I want to say thank you to everyone that have been especially the constituents that are probably listening. Thank you so much for electing me. It's a big honor for me being again elected as the first Latina re-election, and it means a lot, especially for Latinas that are out there that have never been elected or they're never taken the chance to run for office, because I know that it's exhausting and tiring. I want to thank God, first of all, for giving me the strength to continue to serve so many people in Lancaster. Many have reached out to me in situations where there has been a homicide in their family, or if there's a homeless person that needs assistance, or someone that actually has a problem because of mental health. Being that servant means so much, and I am so honored. Second of all, I have to thank my husband, who's here, and also my mother. Unfortunately, I kind of keep her at home because of COVID, but it means so much to me to have their support to continually, they have to have patience for someone like myself, because I take my job so serious that I've taken calls at 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, and I don't know how to stop. I want to thank the mayor for working with her and giving me guidance at times when I needed some type of information that I may not know. Patrick Hopkins as well, when it has to do with financing. Chief Bay, he always answers my call when there are situations, like just recently there was a couple of shootings on Palm Street that unfortunately they're still investigating. And the most favorite thing for me is Steve Campbell. I am very passionate about cleaning Lancaster, making sure our waters are clean. It's really important for us to understand about rainwater and also flooding. That has a lot to do with health, environment, and that obviously I will continue working with him to continue working with Lancaster to understand that they're still working on those situations. Thank you again, and I'm honored.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here. I might be a little bit longer than the other council members because I'm a newcomer. I have a lot of people to thank. So a decade ago, Lancaster welcomed me. And a few minutes ago, I took the oath of office. So there is no way I could do that by myself. And this is the result of hard work and support of many people. First, I would like to thank my wife, my children, my parents for standing by me as I spent my nights knocking on doors and talking to voters. I want to thank the Democratic Committee members who gave me their endorsement, their time, and their effort. My campaign manager, unfortunately, who is not here tonight, Matt Johnson. So Matt, wherever you are, thank you so much for believing in me. And it all started with your ideas. And all of the committee members who gave their effort and the countless time and energy spent to get us all here. I want to thank my fellow candidates for teaching this newcomer the ropes and for being there to discuss the needs of Lancaster residents. Thank you to the mayor for her example of service leadership. I look forward to working closely to achieve our goals. Thanks most of all to the voters of this wonderful city who gave me, an immigrant, the chance to represent the full diversity of our city. Throughout my campaign, I emphasized my commitment to improving community police relations, expanding affordable housing, and making government accessible to everyone in the city. During the next 4 years, I will dedicate myself to that here and look forward to getting started. I also emphasized my ability to represent the thousands of new Americans that call Lancaster home, because I speak Spanish, French, Creole, and English. But let me be clear, I aspire to be a representative for all 60,000 residents of our city. In the near future, I'll be setting up times to have monthly meetings all around the city to hear directly from you about how I can better serve you. I'll be forever grateful for your support and this opportunity to serve my community. Thank you very much.
Good evening, Vincent Derek Smith. Not gonna be before you long, but I do wanna thank you, the community, for voting me into this position. And I want to also say that I am a lifelong Lancaster City resident, and I'm proud to say that I'm from Southeast Lancaster, born and raised. I am a grassroots type of person, on the ground, hands-on individual. So you will see me probably in the city picking up trash, putting up Christmas decorations. Anything you need from me, any outreach, you can just, you know, reach me via Facebook, Vincent Derek Smith. This is my first elected position, and people ask me, how do I feel? I don't feel a victory unless when there's work to still needs to be done. You can't celebrate when there's still work to be done. And I feel like there's still a lot of work to be done. And until that work is done, that's when we celebrate. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I will endeavor to be extremely brief. I'm gonna share two things with you, which I think really get at the heart of the city of Lancaster. But first, let me say thank you. Of course, none of us would be standing here without the work that all of you have done. And I don't just mean in terms of helping us to get elected in coming out to the ballot box. Everything that has happened in the city of Lancaster, anything that we will stand up here and take credit for, is built on your shoulders and on the victories that you won by digging in with your bare hands. And it is my understanding, so here's thing one, that this is the kind of person who defines Lancaster. And I want us to think of Lancaster not as a series of municipal boundaries, but as values that we share and things that we do for our neighbors. One such example, we're picking on you tonight, Chief John Bay. Now, Chief is not from Lancaster originally, but Chief is a Lancastrian. When we were in maybe the most contentious period regarding police community relations in this city's history, Chief Bay came on as our interim police chief. He is now our permanent police chief. We'll take you for as long as you'll stay, thank you. But he dug right in. He jumped immediately into the work and said, this is my community. He turned down no meeting, no opportunity to build a relationship. And that's true, in fact, of the entire executive leadership team. And those are the sorts of people that make Lancaster good. And I think that's each and every one of you in this room or who is watching along at home. And then second, I met a woman several months ago, and of course, thank you to all the staff members who have helped bring us to this point. I met a woman several months ago who was squatting in an apartment from which she had been evicted by her landlord. He had collected some of the federal government's CARES Act funds without investing in her apartment. There were holes in her ceiling, black mold in her bathroom, and she was burning through the money from the two jobs that she worked because she was eating out, ordering in every night for her and her four children because she did not want to use the kitchen in the state that it was. And there are too many people in the city of Lancaster for whom that is simply a reality. And so I will thank, of course, the code inspectors and the folks from CPED who helped take action. But I just want to point out that Lancaster is a place where we are always seeking to do better by our constituents. 4 years ago, we would have had virtually nothing to help that woman. We have a dedicated team in community planning and economic development, and we have a housing caseworker. And that did not come from up here. It didn't even come from the executive leadership team. It came from the community coming and saying and demanding better for their neighbors. And that is how we get it done. We will be, the executive leadership team will be your conduit, but we rely on you. If there can be any victories, also shout out Vincent Derek Smith again. No, this might be the hardest working man in Lancaster. Just real quick. If we can celebrate any victories at all, they are your victories and not ours. And so they will be for the next 4 years. Thank you.
I want to take a moment to just honor and acknowledge our outgoing retiring council member and fiscal officer. First, I want to acknowledge our outgoing controller, Mr. Bill Andrews, who unfortunately could not be here tonight. He has been a steadfast servant to the city of Lancaster for many, many years. We are grateful to his service. And so, in his absence, will you join me in giving him a round of applause? I'd now like to honor retiring council member Pete Soto. Pete, would you come join me for a moment? So Pete and I ran together for council, and I have gotten to know him and his family and have appreciated working with Pete, who he's not a lot, he doesn't talk a lot, but he asks good questions and he pays attention to what's happening, and he'll often follow up or lean across the dais and say, "Hey, Mayor, and like, you know, what's this about?" And so I'm going to miss sitting next to you at council meetings, Pete. And I just want to present this to you, and I'll read it for everyone's benefit. City of Lancaster presented to Pete Soto in appreciation for his service as city councilor January 6th, 2014 through January 3rd, 2022. Lancaster salutes you. Thank you, Mr. Soto.
At this point, I just want to say thank you to the mayor, council, the new candidates, the new councilors, and to the community for the support that I've received for you in the last 8 years on council. It has been an honor and a pleasure, deepest in my heart, to serve on council and give back to the community the best way I can. Like the mayor said, I don't speak too often, but when I need to ask questions, I ask them. And when I need to make a comment, oh God, I'll make the comment. But it has been a pleasure and an honor, and thank you very much. And good luck to the future council.
I believe we have now adjourned from our inaugural ceremonies, and I will turn this over for our organizational meeting of City Council. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Just before we adjourn, my last act as council president in this term will be to appoint Faith Craig as acting president to conduct the organizational meeting, which follows. Councilor Craig, this is yours.
Thank you very much. I always wanted to do that. So that being done, I'd like to call the organizational meeting to order.
I'm sorry. Yes.
The first order of business will be to ask LaShar colleagues to join us at the council table. Perfect. Mr. Harris, will you call roll of council, please?
Yes, Acting President. Mr. Arroyo.
Here.
Ms. Baque.
Here.
Mr. Calexti.
Here.
Ms. Diaz.
Here.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Here.
Mr. Smith-Lloydell.
Here.
And Acting President Craig.
Here. Thank you, Mr. Harris. Now I'd like to call for election of president of council. Opening the table for nominations.
Council President, I'd like to make a motion to nominate Councilor Ismael Smith-Wadeau for council president.
Second.
Second.
Thank you. There's been a motion and a second. Mr. Harris, can we call for a vote?
Yes, Ms. Acting President. Mr. Arroyo.
Aye.
Ms. Baque.
Aye.
Mr. Calexti.
Aye.
Ms. Diaz.
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Aye.
And Mr. Smith-Wadeau.
Aye.
And Acting President Craig.
Aye. By unanimous vote, it has been Councilor President Ismael Smith-Wadeau is our council president again, by the vote of everyone. There you go. So there you go. I'm gonna give that back to you.
Thank you very kindly, Councilor Craig. The agenda gives remarks of the former president and remarks of the newly elected president. I won't do that to you, and I will simply, my remarks as newly elected council president are simply thank you. We move now to new business. As you may or may not be aware, the department heads serve at the pleasure of the mayor with the ratification of city council. And so our first business will be resolutions reappointing, or addressing resolutions reappointing several key city officials. And with that, administration resolution number one, 2022. Mr. Harris.
Yes, Mr. President. A resolution of the Council of the City of Lancaster approving the appointment of Barry N. Hanwerger by Mayor Danene Sorace as City Solicitor for a term of 4 years.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Council comments. Hearing none, Mr. Harris.
Mr. Arroyo.
Aye.
Ms. Baque.
Aye.
Mr. Calexi.
Aye.
Ms. Craig?
Aye.
Ms. Diaz?
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina?
Aye.
And President Smith-Wadeau?
Aye. Congratulations. Administration resolution number two, 2022. Mr. Harris.
A resolution of the Council of the City of Lancaster approving the appointment of the Director of the Department of Administrative Services.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Council comments. Hearing none, Mr. Harris.
Mr. Arroyo.
Aye.
Ms. Baque.
Aye.
Mr. Calexti.
Aye.
Ms. Craig.
Aye.
Ms. Diaz.
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Aye.
And President Smith Waddell.
Aye. Congratulations, Patrick. That brings us to administration resolution number 3. Mr. Harris, if you would.
A resolution of the Council of the City of Lancaster approving the appointment of the Director of the Department of Community Planning and Economic Development.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, councilors. Any comment? Hearing none, Mr. Harris.
Mr. Royo.
Aye.
Ms. Baque.
Aye.
Mr. Kalexti.
Aye.
Ms. Gregg.
Aye.
Ms. Diaz.
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Aye.
And President Smith Waddell.
Aye. Congratulations, Chris. Which brings us to our last piece of legislative action for the night, administration resolution number 4, 2022. Mr. Harris.
A resolution of the Council of the City of Lancaster approving the appointment of the Director of the Department of Public Works.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, councilors. Any comment? Hearing none. One more time, Mr. Harris.
Mr. Royo.
Aye.
Ms. Baque.
Aye.
Mr. Kalexti.
Aye.
Ms. Gregg.
Aye.
Ms. Diaz.
Aye.
Mr. Garcia Molina.
Aye.
And President Smith Waddell.
Aye. Steven, there we go. Congratulations, sir. Okay, so for the first time this year, that concludes our legislative agenda. Thanks for hanging in. It is my distinct honor, just as we were called together a little while earlier, to invite the honorable, the delightful, and gregarious Reverend Roland Forbes to the podium to send us to go in peace.
Said so. The word benediction simply means to release a blessing. It's so serious in the Word of God that the Bible tells us not to release a blessing without there being one to receive it. I want to bless not only the mayor and this council, but our city. Such a turbulent time of pandemic and political turmoil, we could all stand a blessing. I'm going to ask him we all stand. God, our creator, we're grateful. You allowed us to survive and thrive. You allowed us to be united together. Share with us the fact that the earth is yours, fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. So, Father, we release your blessings upon the mayor, upon this council, upon every city officer, every city resident, that, Father, that we would be a shining example set upon a hill in order that we might offer light in the midst of darkness. Guide every proposal, touch every heart, and above all, teach us to love and respect one another. Do this all in the name of our Creator. Amen. And amen.
Councilors, may I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
We are adjourned. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much.